Hello and welcome to this carol service. A different form this year. We would normally, as you know, be at St Mildred's Church all together. So here we are at St Matthew's recording this service on this occasion. But I hope that you will really feel that you are part of this occasion as we hear familiar words, as we listen together, and hopefully you'll join in with the singing at home, and that you feel that you are really taking part in this celebration once again of the birth of our Saviour. So we'll begin with the bidding prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that we can be here together, united and yet separate. And God, as we hear familiar readings, carols, the story again of the birth of the Saviour, help us, Lord, in our hearts and minds to go even unto Bethlehem and to see this thing which has come to pass and the babe lying in a manger. And help us, Lord, at this time of year, as we celebrate this gift, the greatest gift of all, to know that you are with us, that you are Emmanuel. And God, as we give and receive presents, help us, Lord, to remember those who are in desperate need, the poor, the asylum seekers and refugees, those affected by natural disasters around the world, those living under tyranny and oppression. And God, may you come close to us as we rejoice in your love and goodness, lift up our hearts and lift up our lives. And may this service, Lord, give you glory, honor, and praise. Through our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
A secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Now it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor falls, the major lift, the baffled king composing. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty and the moonlight overthrew her. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, people, I've been here before. I know this room and I've walked this door. You see, I used to live alone before I knew ya. And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. A mass in love is not a victory march. It's a code and it's a broken hallelujah.
For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
They say this mountain can't be moved. They say these chains will never break. But they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We've heard that there is no way through. We've heard the tide will never change. They haven't seen what you can do. There is power in your name, so much power in your name. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe, God, we believe for it from the impossible. We'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. We know that hope is never lost. For there is still an empty grave. God, we believe no matter. even for us, Noel.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and there repining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees. Oh, hear the angels' voices. All night divine. Oh, night when Christ was born.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you this child that you delivered was to deliver you?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand?
Hello, everyone. So I'm just going to talk for a couple of minutes about our fantastic collection that we did earlier on this term for The Vine in New Addington and St. Francis Food Stop. And I'm going to think for a couple of minutes about what that might mean for us as a school community. Now, in some people's churches at Christmas, what we have is we have what's called the Advent Collect. It's like the Advent special prayer, which gets prayed by some people every Sunday in the lead up to Christmas. The Advent Collect goes like this. It says, Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armour of light. Then it goes on to say, now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through him who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. And I know this prayer quite well, and I love this prayer. But maybe we ought to think for a minute about what this prayer actually means for us. And sometimes it's possible to look at this prayer in, well, I guess a fairly sort of selfish type of way. When it talks about on the last day we're going to rise again and we're going to stand in front of Jesus and he's going to judge the living and the dead. I suppose it's a little bit like the parable of the sheep and the goats, really. So the parable of the sheep and the goats in Matthew 25, it talks about the idea of Jesus will stand in glory and he'll separate out those on his right who are the sheep and those on his left who are the goats. And he'll say to those on the right, come into the kingdom, for I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. And sometimes it's possible to perform acts of charity for what we think might be quite selfish reasons, because what we think is, well, you know, God's going to be pleased with what we've done, and somewhere along the line, there's a little bit of a reward in it for us. But actually, I think there's a very different reason. And I think that reason is to be found in the first chapter of John's Gospel. And this is another very famous Christmas reading, which you will find in a lot of your churches on the Sunday before Christmas. And the start of the Gospel of John goes like this. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made, and without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. In supporting the Vine and St. Francis Food Banks, we are the light. We are the light of Jesus that shines in the world now. We are witnesses of the light that shines for everybody at Christmas. And it's not just in our acts of charitable giving for other people. Every time we pray for a friend who's got COVID. Every time we send a Christmas card to a friend of ours, we are proclaiming the light of Jesus in our world this Christmas. And we are saying that Jesus is the light that shines in the darkness. And the darkness will never overcome it. I want to wish you a wonderful, joyous, and a blessed Christmas. And I want to pray that everyone in our school community and everyone linked with our school community is going to have an absolutely brilliant time. And may we be the light that shines in the darkness to show the love of God to others.
Let's bow our heads to pray. Lord Jesus Christ, your birth at Bethlehem draws us to kneel in wonder at heaven touching earth. Accept our heartfelt praise as we worship you, our Saviour and our eternal God. Loving Jesus, you were born in a stable but worshipped by the angels. Be with those who are lonely and with all who feel distant from celebrations. Be for us a living hope that lightens their hearts. Jesus, as you healed the sick, bring healing to those in our families who are ill today. Christ, born for us, Son of God given for us, help us to know you, to worship and to serve you. The kings bought myrrh, frankincense and gold. Lord, we have nothing of our own to bring. We bring you what we have been given, our lives for you. Jesus, Saviour, Son of Mary, you know and love us. You share our lives and you hear our prayers. Glory to you forever. Amen. And we join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
blinded by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace, by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace. I'm blinded by your, Lord, I've
been broken. Although I'm not worthy, you fix me. Now I'm blinded by your grace. You came and saved me, Lord, I've been broken. Although I'm not worthy, you fix me. Now I'm blinded by your grace. You came and saved me.
One time for the Lord, and one time for the cause, and one round of applause, one time for Fraser T. Smith on the chords. I thought we got one, I still prayed up, then I get the job done. Yeah, I'm Abigail's youth, but I'm God's son. But I'm up now, look at what God's done. Now real talk, look at what God did. On the main stage, running around topless. My phone flips and we telling that we got this. But this is God's plan, we can never stop this. Like, wait right there, can you stop my verse? You saved this kid and I'm not your first. It's not by blood and it's not by birth. But oh my God, what a God I serve, yeah.
Like me, you must be disappointed that we could not be here in person. But like me, I hope that you're hugely encouraged by what Mr. Potts and all his choirs and Mike Rutt and all those who participated in this service have managed to produce for us today. So now Christmas truly can come, now that we've celebrated it as a school community. And I particularly want to thank Mr. Potts and Mrs. Gravett and all our music department for all the time and effort and energy they put into this. And most particularly Mr. Potts for his arrangement of this and all the technological hurdles that he's overcome. And I wish you all, on behalf of the school, a very happy Christmas.
His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His
And so we draw our service to a conclusion with the blessing. God, who by the incarnation of his Son, Jesus Christ, gathered together all things earthly and heavenly, fill you with peace and goodwill as you celebrate the birth of the Christ child. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you, and all those whom you love and all those for whom you pray, this day, this Christmas, and forevermore. Amen.